everybody, Dr. Cranky here with another segment of what is the right airbrush for you. We are entering the Iwata realm, the realm of the Iwata. Yes, I want my Iwata. I really, really want my Iwata. Some very fine, did I say fine, airbrushes. I first learned of them from talking to Craig Frazier and a couple of folks over at Spray Kings, and also the good friends at Coast Airbrush. And so we are going to devote quite a bit of time going over some of the models that we use here in the laboratory. You just watch me paint the 64 Impala and a few other models with this. This is the Iwata HP M2. There's also an M1, but this is the M2. And it comes with a 7mm cup, and which holds quite a bit of paint. You know, you could do probably a coat or two. Now, this is not a detail airbrush. I mean, this is not a detail work airbrush, okay? It works basically at the level of the pache, meaning that it really, you dial in how much paint back here, you know? And the wider out, okay, the more paint and more air. This too is a single airbrush, single action airbrush. So it's a great transition from the folks who learned to use the pache. And, you know, and so it's a sturdy, very well made, actually kind of a work of art airbrush made in Japan. I usually will remove here it's a little stuck, but I normally remove the crown cap and use it that way I can keep it clean. It's it has a wonderful spray pattern to it, and great coverage. It's a good airbrush all around for spraying, again, clear coats, metallizer paints, base coats, in particular white base coats. I'm getting ready to shoot some white, both the pearl white and also the regular white from House of Color. It's kind of a high pigmented paint, and so it requires really quite an open nozzle so that it flows really smooth and really well. Anyway, it comes in this wonderful packaging, and here you see the difference between the M2 and the M1. I just went for the M2 just because if I'm spraying, for example, testers clear, I want to be able to hold a little bit more. And of course, this airbrush was designed for low pressure applications. So, and by low pressure, I would imagine they're talking about, again, that range between 25 and 35 PSI. Woo! Hey, the box went running. So, you know, check it out. It's not cheap. None of the Iwata airbrushes are cheap. Now, what are they? Well, they are a great investment. It's the kind of tool that's well made, and if you take good care of it, it will bring you many, many, many years of, you know, there's the needle right there. Very easy to clean. It will bring you many, many years of uninterrupted airbrushing. So take care of your tools and they will take good care of you. So anyway, the Iwata Revolution M2. Check it out and, you know, ask around. The other thing I wanted to say is that Tube King has a sale going on. and Bill, and he's got, I believe he told me he's got an extra 10% off on all Iwata products. So I will post a link to his website and you can check it out. But also look around. I mean, somebody should be able to give you a good deal on the Iwata, you know, airbrushes and the entire line parts. You know, they've got all sorts of wonderful guns. And so this is the beginning of it. So do stay tuned in for more of these airbrush reviews. And one more thing I want to say before I let you go is... this one has no stock, really, so you could literally, you know, learn to airbrush like this if it's more comfortable. I normally do it like that, or, you know, you could hold it in a variety of ways, but what you learn that I talked about in the pache in terms of stroke and all that, it's the same thing here, okay? Same mechanism, press down for shooting, release for stopping both flow and paint. It comes with a nice handy cap that you must use at all times to avoid heartbreak. Anyway, my friends, let me know what you think. More reviews coming your way. Thank you so much. And also, I hope you enjoyed the little music. We're trying. All right. See you on the next one. Bye-bye.